Hey, everybody, it's Alan. Hope that you are doing well. I'm a big fan of The Police, and I will honestly tell you, my favorite member of that band is the drummer, Stewart Copeland. I saw an interview with him very recently, and he was asked what his most difficult drum part was to play. And he said, "Spirits in the Material World." Let's check it out. With that in mind, let's check it out and get an idea on what Stewart Copeland thought was his most difficult drum part. To stop that, and we're going to go all the way back to the beginning, because I remembered while I was listening to it with y'all what Stewart said he thought was the most interesting part, and I want you to listen to it again with this in mind. And I hear it. There's no one. What I mean by that is there's no one. You know, normally you go 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4. Normally when a drummer is playing a drum part, there's a one. The downbeat is the first beat, right? It's like 1 2 3 4, 1 2. You know, you're thinking about it. Think about a click track. When you think about a click, it's like you always think 1 2 3 4, 1 or whatever. There's no one. He never hits the one. He never plays on the one. Check it out again. We'll be right back. Stewart Copeland is probably the biggest reason why whenever I hear bands try to cover or perform a Police song, they never feel or seem like they get it right. His drumming is so incredibly unique, and a lot of it has to do with his upbringing. He basically, you know, his family moved around a little bit. He was somewhat raised in the Middle East. I feel like the story is something to the effect of, like, his dad was in the military or whatever it was, and so he and his family and his brother were brought up, you know, essentially over in military or over in other countries, not here in the U.S. And so he listened to music that didn't exactly, well, it wasn't set to the standard Western, you know, Western beat. It wasn't set to the Western time signatures. And that definitely influenced his drumming as he got better and better and progressed. He was, to a certain extent, very familiar with playing offbeat, off time, off tempo, what have you. And so when you listen to songs like this, or you listen to a song like Murder by Numbers, the drumming isn't a standard classic 2-4, you know, rock beat. It isn't. It is not. And that's the mistake, and that's a big reason why a lot of other drummers who aren't as, you know, well-versed or trained can't pull off Police songs properly, because they're not used to that odd drum part, that odd timing. It's really something that has always made the Police a very unique band. And I know a lot of people like to throw out, you know, the reggae inspiration that has itself inside of the Police's guitar tones and stuff like that. And it's definitely there, but the rhythm parts definitely have a little bit more of a Middle Eastern kind of feel to them, at least several of them. I can't say they all do, you know. I don't know if I'd have to go back and, with all of this in mind, go back and listen to a song like Synchronicity or Synchronicity 2, or, you know, even something as, I'm not going to go listen to Every Breath You Take or Wrapped Around Your Finger, because those songs, they were on way too much when I was growing up, and they've kind of worn their welcome out in my brain. But go back when you get a chance, go back and listen to some other Police tracks, and just pay particular attention to the drumming, and you'll notice that it is not your run-of-the-mill, classic, standard, Western type of drum timing. You know, it has a different inflection to it almost in every single instance. Well, that said, I think it was fun listening to that, having listened to the Stewart Copeland interview. I think it was a very interesting thing. I hadn't actually given it much thought regarding, like, this particular song not having a one. Like, he never hits on the downbeat like so many other drummers would. You know what I mean? It's very interesting to me. That said, hope you all enjoyed this. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section. We can talk about it further. Just know that I appreciate you all, and I wish you well. Take care.